As we leave Damascus for Homs, in the outskirts of the Syrian capital, the devastation of the war is clearly visible. This road was only reopened by government forces 2 months ago, and it still isn't always safe.
These are the districts of Adra, Harasta, and Duma, and there was very heavy fighting on this very road until recently. The rebels still control large parts of this area, so we're going to have to try and get through here as fast as we can.
The highway to Homs leads mostly through the desert. There used to be fighting here as well. In Homs, some districts lay in ruins after 2.5 years of fighting, and people are just now beginning to pick up the pieces.
They've only just started the cleanup effort here in Homs, and as you can see, there's still quite a lot that they have to do. Homs is one of those places where you go there after the battle is over and you can still feel how heavy and how hard the fighting must have been. You can see the shutters of this building here absolutely destroyed. All the houses are pockmarked, and also you can see that a lot of very heavy weapons were used in the urban combat here. If we look over there, the bottom floor of that building is totally burned out. There must have been some massive fire there. Up there, you can actually look into someone's living room because that house is totally destroyed as well. And just from that, you can see how long it's going to take for them to rebuild this place. And it's not just rebuilding the material things. It's also trying to rebuild the social fabric of this community to get people to actually live together again.
Sunnis, Christians, and Alawites live in deep distrust of each other after more than 2 years of civil war. Their common history in this town has also been damaged, as the sunlight creates a surreal mood in the burned and broken ancient bazaar.
Homs is a town with thousands of years of history, but of course that didn't matter at all to the warring factions. They fought as hard as they could here, and the old town of Homs, the ancient bazaar for instance, was completely destroyed and burned out. If you look up there, those stones up there are thousands of years old, and of course none of that is in any way replaceable. And sometimes I really wonder, after an assignment like this one, how I'm going to go home and tell my children that all of this was destroyed in our times and we, the world, didn't do anything to prevent it.
But now that the battle for Homs is over, the people of this town have a chance to rebuild and maybe one day move on together. Fred-Pleitgen, CNN, Homs, Syria.